Listening Library presents Witches of Brooklyn, S'more Magic by Sophie Escabasse. Read for you by a full cast. Chapter 1. At the end of June in Dimmis Park, on a bright and hot summery afternoon.
I wish you guys were coming with me to those stinking woods. I don't want to spend the summer in the woods, and away from you, and away from Brooklyn, and away from civilization.
It isn't the whole summer, Effie. It's just a month.
Come on, Effie. You'll still have running water and electricity. Can't be that bad.
Easy for you to say, madame who goes to France all summer.
I can't wait. I'm finally gonna see my grandma. I'm so happy.
We're happy for you, Garance.
Yeah, I know you've been dying to go back for months.
You better bring us some souvenirs.
Barrett, you're the worst.
It really sucks that both Effie and I go to sleepaway camp, but it's not the same camp. Why are your aunts sending you to...
Raccoon camp in the something mountains.
Right. What's wrong with upstate New York?
Nothing's wrong with your camp, Barrett. It's a family thing. The place I'm going to is some sort of obligatory rite of passage.
And you, Oliver, are you doing the robotics day camp again?
Yes, I'm pretty excited because I will be animating in some classes this year.
Wow, that's cool.
Thanks.
It would be even cooler if he could build something useful, like a time machine.
A time machine? 'Cause it is so easy.
Come on, Oliver. Where is your ambition?
Do you guys want to come in for some lemonade?
I'm meeting with my sister. We're gonna go shopping for my aunt's birthday.
Group hug! I have to go too! I'll miss us!
I'll send postcards.
I'll write you letters from camp.
Oh, where's the lemonade, Effie? I'm dying.
This way, drama queen.
It feels so good. How can it be so hot already?
I know. It's intense.
We should head to the basement or Francis will be upset again. So, is that camp for witches? Is it some sort of summer seminar about magic? I'm almost jealous.
Don't be. There's some witchy part, but Selamine and Carlotta are kind of secretive about it. Like, they want to preserve the mystery of the place.
That sounds pretty exciting to me. You'll have to tell me everything you learn, okay?
I'll try.
Hello, ducklings!
Hi, Francis!
Ah, Francis, the temperature in here is just divine.
I know. Nothing but perfection for my books. Always. We won't have class today. I just wanted to wish you both a nice summer. And to give you this.
What is it?
A teapot. What do you think it is, Effie? A book, of course. I want you to use it as a journal, ladies, and to write down everything you'll learn, see, and experience over the summer. If you have questions for me, you can write them on the last page of the book, and I'll try to answer them. Please be safe. Oh, and come back to me in one piece.
Oh, can I stay a bit longer? It's so nice in here.
You'll answer the questions when we come back, or you'll do it right away in the book?
Good question. It will be right away. As long as I know the answer to it. Obviously.
Neat.
Indeed.
We should call each other when we're away. Sissy made my necklace into a jewel Eunice last week so that we'll be able to stay in touch for my classes. Boy, I hope she'll remember the time difference.
She'll definitely wake you up a bunch of times. Get used to the idea.
I know.
I've never called anyone but Selamine and Carlotta with my necklace, though. How would I reach you?
A jewel Eunice is usually a piece of jewelry a witch can use to communicate with another witch from far away. Any jewel can be turned into a jewel Eunice as long as it's made of silver or gold. Encrusted stones make communication easier, but aren't necessary. The only thing you'll need to do to reach the person you wish to talk to is to think of them intently.
Thanks, Francis.
Should we give it a try?
I'll go in that corner, and you take the opposite one.
Mini Bear to Raccoon? Do you hear me, Raccoon?
Loud and clear, Mini Bear. My turn to call.
Can you hear?
Yes! Loud and clear!
Oops. Too loud, I think.
Bye, Francis!
Bye, ducklings!
Safe trip, Co-Witch.
You too, Effie. You'll be fine. You always are.
Not quite knowing what to do with herself after saying goodbye to her friend, Effie goes to see Carlotta in the greenhouse.
Are you all right, honey? You're sad you've said goodbye to your friends. It's only for the summer, sweetie.
Do I really have to go, Carlotta?
Oh, yes. And I assure you that you'll be much happier and comfortable in the woods than here. Did you know that the temperature in the woods is always significantly cooler? Thanks to the trees. Aren't you curious to see if you have a green thumb? A wood immersion can trigger it.
I thought I was doing well with plants.
Of course! You're fantastic with plants. I'm talking about the real green thumb.
What do you mean, the real green thumb?
Lemonade time, ladies!
And Bert Muffin time again.
Well, that is the way I like them.
Sure. I'll remove the burnt crust if you don't mind.
So I was saying that the expression green thumb comes from witches.
Oh, yeah. It's a real thing.
Are you making fun of me right now?
Absolutely not, honey. But not all witches have it, of course.
Do you have it? Your thumbs aren't green.
They don't stay green forever, Pumpkin.
And yes, both Selamine and I experienced a plant bonding.
I have a special connection with graminae, the fancy word for grasses. The tall ones like bamboos, the small ones in the pastures, and everything in between. I connect with them all.
And I bond with trees. No chatty bushes, big trees.
It all sounds really nice, but what if I don't have a green thumb? What if I spend the summer trying to talk to plants that don't talk back?
You won't have a conversation in a way you're implying, my dear. That's not the way it works.
It isn't for the whole summer, Sugar Puff. It's just for a month. And it isn't a big deal at all if you... I guess you do need to remove the burnt crust from those muffins. So, yeah, not a big deal at all if you don't have a green thumb. We still think it's important that you're given the chance to bond with nature. Green thumb, but no green thumb.
Hey you, little leafy plant. Can you tell them that I'll be fine bonding with nature from Brooklyn? See? No answer. I'll go upstairs to finish my packing. I'll miss you, Lion.
Enjoy your bed, Sugar Puff. Tomorrow, it's hard rocks and straw.
Ha ha, you're hilarious.
Love you.
Around 2 a.m., a couple of blocks away from the witch's house, a hooded figure moves slowly along the sidewalk.
I love your pants, man. Rad. The thank you?
He reaches the front yard, climbs the few steps, and takes out a set of keys.
Hello, you little fella. Long time no see. The bed is gonna feel so good.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.